We talk a lot about fat, how to lose fat, how fast we can do that, where the fat goes, and to even know that my personal body fat percentage is 12.8%. At least it was 12.8% a year ago when I did my fat measurements. Actually, as you might remember, it was somewhere between 9.2% and 14.2%, depending on the measuring method. So, we all have fat, and it's good to have some fat. But I'm sure that you've heard that excessive fat is unhealthy. I don't think anyone is arguing the opposite. So, how unhealthy is to have an excessive fat? Let's talk about the price we pay for having excessive fat in our body. Coming up! Hi, Andre here. Welcome to The Practical Health. Having excessive fat means being overweight or obese. What is considered overweight? According to the World Health Organization, overweight is the abnormal or excessive accumulation of fat inside the body. How do you know whether you are overweight or not? The most accurate way of figuring that out is the DEXA scan. But it's not available everywhere and it's quite expensive. So, the simplest way to understand whether you are overweight is to calculate your body mass index or BMI. This is a scale that measures your body fat based on your height and weight. Divide your weight in kilograms by the square of your height in meters. If the result is between 18.5 and 24.9, then congratulations, your weight is within the normal range. If your BMI is above 25, then you are in overweight range. Or if your BMI is above 30, then sorry to break it to you, but you are technically obese. Obesity is basically a more severe form of being overweight. As an example, let's calculate my BMI. My height is 185 cm and my weight is 73.5 kg. So my BMI is 15,000. Wait, no, that's not right. Okay, actually my BMI is 21.5. Okay, I'm within the normal range. Good job, Andre. Okay, one point here. BMI is not the most accurate way of assessing body fat. It doesn't take into account body type, muscle mass, and many other factors, but it's a good estimate and quite widely used due to its simplicity. Is obesity a common thing? You better believe me. Very common. In the United States, about 70% of adults are either overweight or obese. On a worldwide scale, 1.9 billion adults over the age of 18 are overweight. It's quite depressing. In my case, if I wanted to get into that overweight category for some reason, I would need to gain 12 kilograms or 26 pounds of extra fat, or an additional 16% of my total weight. That's quite a lot. I guess that means I could afford to sneak a couple of extra cookies. Probably. So, what does it mean for your bodily operations to have that extra fat? Several things. One, your body needs to store that fat somewhere within the body. Two, it will carry this fat everywhere. And then three, your body will have to manage all the hormones that the fat produces. So let's talk about each of these points. First, storing fat. The most convenient place to store fat in our bodies is right under the skin. Here, here, here. This type of fat is called subcutaneous fat. Research showed that on average, about 90% of the fat in our body is subcutaneous fat. By the way, based on my DEXA scan, 99% of my fat is subcutaneous fat. Yes, yes, I know you're impressed by the percentage of my subcutaneous fat, but let's move on. The health problems with the extra fat right under the skin include potential skin infections, skin tags, and many other skin-related diseases. The rest of the fat is being stored in the abdominal cavity. This fat is called the visceral fat. One of the issues with the visceral fat from a storage perspective is that it takes up space in the abdominal cavity and limits the motion of lungs. You don't want fat taking priority over your lungs, right? Second, carrying an extra weight creates a load on your musculoskeletal system and especially puts an extra strain on your joints. Most commonly affected joints in this case are in the hands, knees, hips, and spine. Those extra pounds make your joints more prone to inflammation that can result in osteoarthritis, degenerative joint disease or wear and tear arthritis. Painful joints can make even simple walking difficult, surely limiting our daily activities. An extra pound in body weight gives around 4 pounds of extra pressure on your poor little knees. Next problem with excessive fat in the body is that fat accumulates on the walls of blood vessels in the form of cholesterol. It's called atherosclerosis. This will make blood vessels narrow and result in higher blood pressure or hypertension. Hypertension can damage your arteries and heart, lead to brain diseases like dementia and TIA, damage your kidneys and eyes, result in sexual dysfunction and lead to many other diseases. None of those things are good. And in extreme case, hypertension can result in heart failure and stroke. Your heart's coronary vessels will also be constricted by the atherosclerosis, limiting the blood supply to the heart muscles. If your heart muscles are not getting enough oxygen, they will die, causing a heart attack. I probably shouldn't have to say this, but killing parts of your heart is very bad. Ischemic heart disease, also called coronary heart disease, is the world's leading cause of death. About 10 million people die from ischemic heart disease annually. Finally, adipose tissue is no longer considered to be an inert tissue that stores fat. It is responsible for the synthesis and secretion of several hormones, such as control of nutritional intake, leptin, estrogen, angiotensin, control of sensitivity to insulin and inflammatory process mediators, among others. Leptin, a hormone predominantly produced by fat cells, causes your kidneys to excrete less water than normal, further contributing to the high blood pressure. Excessive estrogen hormone in the human body has been associated with increased risk of cancer. The most common cancers related to being overweight or obese are breast, colorectal, lung, liver, kidney, and bladder cancers. Visceral fat that builds up inside your liver can cause inflammation, known as non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. This condition often leads to several complications, such as cirrhosis and liver failure. And finally, as you can imagine, issues in controlling insulin sensitivity caused by the fat can lead to the development of insulin resistance, which is the main cause of type 2 diabetes. It is plain to see that excessive amounts of fat damages the body in a big way, since we need to store it, carry it everywhere we go, and manage the hormones it produces. Scientists estimate that severely obese people have a 6-12 times higher death rate due to overall causes than normal people. 6-12 times, that's extreme. The point is that being overweight or obese is a bad news for your body. So stay strong, stay healthy, and maintain a healthy weight. It will pay off in the long run. If you like this video, hit that like button and subscribe to our Practical Health channel. I've heard from some viewer that when you subscribe, the fat cells in your body get scared and attempt to flee. Don't forget to share this video with your family and friends to spread awareness of our channel. We'll appreciate that. By the way, you might notice that the picture of this video is a bit crisper than we had before. That's because now we're shooting on a fancy 4K camera. See you next time. Bye.